Thanks for tuning in. This is our 1,000 subscriber episode. We're so grateful to have so many people tuning in, checking it out, watching the podcast and watching the videos that we talk about AI here on Stable Discussion. Honestly, just so thrilled. And it's been great seeing all the chat messages. It's been great to kind of converse with other people who are also as interested in AI as we are. And so that's been just really great. We're somewhat above the hype here, but also excited about kind of new things like the release of ChatGPT-4o. Came out just in time to help us celebrate, so that's nice of OpenAI for that. I kind of wanted to go back to some of the kind of early asks that some of the comments have reached out for about specifically how we built the PDF parsing that we did in our AD&D rulebook. This rulebook is an app that I built. What it does is it looks through the Advanced Dungeons & Dragons player's handbook and a few other sources, and it'll pull out rules from these documents, these very old PDFs. And I had a lot of questions about how do you prepare PDFs? How do you parse them? What's sort of the process there? And as I kind of looked at what ChatGPT did and the current state of the code that I had used to build this, I realized a couple things. One, LangChain has changed completely since the early days of what I used to build this code base. So the code is fairly broken at this point. I was thinking about maybe releasing it or going through that, but at this point, I just think it's too far away from the current mark that it's not that helpful. I already kind of talked about like the high level of sort of what I went through, but also kind of looking at the new GPT-4o, I'm kind of also rethinking how we even think about parsing PDFs. We've got these old PDFs that have these tables, a lot of visual elements as well as text. And with so much cool visual stuff going on in the new models, it kind of makes me think differently about how I think about PDF parsing. And so I wanted to kind of double click on that. I think this will be a good kind of deep dive into how we think about PDFs and really like what the strengths are of the kind of existing systems. This should give you a deeper view as to what these models are currently capable of and how adjusting your approach can have a dramatically different outcome. If you look at like PDF documents like this, there's really two ways to look at them. One is kind of like the rendered document. That's what you see when you kind of preview a PDF. You can see all the images, you can see all the text inside of them. That's really just like one way to look at them. The other way is as a kind of like raw text document. And if you were to like convert this into a text document, you would be able to tell that it's kind of able to pull out some of the text, but there are some times where some of the ways that the text in this is stored may be a bit confusing. And we'll kind of dive a little bit deeper into that, but there's kind of problems with both of these approaches. One, with the raw document, you often get a lot of like bad formats. You get issues where, because this is like a multi-column document, you get some reading on this side and then it suddenly jumps across. And so you get this like weirdness where the text just isn't read correctly. The other thing you get is like sometimes where the header and footer bleeds into the text. So you might be going through and parsing this file. You get to the end of this page and then suddenly it starts reading out the header for the next page. And that gets kind of uncomfortable. You can sometimes handle it, and there's some libraries that do a pretty good job, but it depends on how the PDF's formatted. And, you know, you get all sorts of like malformed text, line breaks. There's all sorts of problems with the raw document. And we'll actually look at an example of those in a bit. On the other end, you've got like the rendered document. And the rendered document itself could be like rendered out as like an image even. So we could take screenshots of these, or we could take the PDF and have it output this as a series of images. That's definitely another way of doing it. And then you can use something like OCR or optical character recognition. And that will sort of try and do this process of like converting this rendered document into raw text. But the problem is it's generally ends up being kind of similar to the raw text anyway. Usually doesn't do a great job. And what we're kind of seeing now is like LLMs, AIs are almost better than a lot of the OCR models that we used to be using. So it might be actually better to be using some of these like AI models if you can. You also get some like inconsistencies in formatting that can become an issue. So if you've got these rendered documents, the nice thing about the raw documents is every page is structured the same. It may be malformed and awful, but at least it's structured the same way. But with a rendered document and you reading it through a custom, in a custom means, you may not be able to find the page number sometimes, or you may have inconsistencies between pages that you aren't able to kind of reconcile in an easy way. So that becomes its own problem. But this is sort of like the current state of PDFs. And this is like currently supported in like ChatGPT. We can kind of currently parse PDFs in ChatGPT. We just don't really know like what do they do in the background. And so I actually went ahead and kind of did this on my end. I uploaded a bestiary to ChatGPT. I said, hey, review this PDF, see if it makes sense to you. If, when you're ready, how far can this monster move? And it correctly told me off of some random page how far that monster could move. And I was like, okay, well, that's pretty good. Then I looked at like a monster table. So, you know, like one of these tables here that has a bunch of different stats on it. And I said, cool, like, what are the stats if I roll a 5 on that table? And it gave me a monster. It gave me the correct monster. It gave me some details. It pulled some details from somewhere else that I couldn't quite find, but it missed AT and HD. Even when I asked for them, it wasn't able to come up with the right numbers. And so I actually had to like show it an image of like what I meant. And I was like, you should be reading out of this table. And it's like, oh, it could read the highlighted text now and it could kind of find that. But when it was looking at it via PDF, it couldn't figure out what those values were. And the value, the uploaded image is like impossible to read, but you can kind of see it here. You've got the HD, AT, these two values just didn't exist. And when it was trying to come up with those values, it was assuming it was like 1 and 2 to 4, but the actual value is like 1/2 or 1 or 1. So it was just off completely. I don't know where it was getting those numbers from. So anyway, so it could get that part. And then when I asked it, hey, okay, well, what page did you find that on? It actually quoted me the wrong page. And it may be the page, like the page numbers that were from the PDF, potentially, like, but you can tell, like, this is actually page like 101 of 128. It's not page 99. And I think even in the actual written pages for this, it was not 99 either. So anyway, ChatGPT has some issues parsing PDFs. It does a pretty good job. I mean, it can find you stuff. The problem is, I think it is dangerous enough to be misleading. It can understand some things, but it sort of doesn't show you how it went about that process of finding the thing. And because it can't source the exact part of the PDF it got something from, it really like can be quite misleading as to what's going on here. So I think this is a big kind of miss on ChatGPT's side. So I took it upon myself to test this out. Okay. We have these kind of two ways of seeing PDF. We got this fancy new API that we can try some stuff out in. So let's give it a go. So what I did was I basically took this and I said, cool, I've got a photo of a PDF. And that photo is this image right here. You can see it here. So I uploaded this image and I said, cool, I've got this. Can you please read it and return me the formatted text based on the image? Similarly, I went through and I actually uploaded the equivalent raw document that we had. And you can actually tell this raw document is rough. You can see this mangled bit of text here. You can see that there's a lot of things kind of running together. Here you can see the start of a table, but you can't really tell what any of these values go to. There's some random lines of values here that may line up with the values up here, but it's quite difficult to tell. And so I tasked GPT-o, GPT-4 Vision across both of these to just give me some output. Tell me how good are you at solving this problem now? So let's start with the raw document, which is kind of similar to what I was doing before. I would kind of like send these raw documents to ChatGPT. I'd be like, hey, can you kind of like try and fix some OCR errors that might exist in these files? And it would come back and it would give me something like this. So you can see here, it has a heading, it's got a subheading, it's got a bit of a table. I'm not quite sure what this relates to compared to those big tables, but okay. It has some formatted text and it pulled some of the text together. Okay, great. And I think the previous version did about the same. It missed the table. So, you know, this one is kind of doing a better job of figuring out, oh, there might have been a table here or something. It's doing some formatting. This one wasn't. But overall, it's a pretty similar look. Now, when we look at these, we're actually just uploading an image. You can actually see that GPT-4 Vision Preview did a pretty good job. It grabbed some of the headings, grabbed this table, didn't quite format it, but it tried. It went through and pulled out the other table as well as pulling along the supporting text. But when we look at 4o, of course, we've got a much better formatted table. So you can see here, we've got the headings, we've got the dexterity table start, you've got the table values here, the notes for that table. Then you've got this beginning of this paragraph, the table that was included over here, the small bonus text at the bottom, and then the other notes that were going to exist over here. And I actually even went it further and just said, hey, can you write a short description of the image that you kind of see in this document? And it actually kind of looked at the image, pulled out some stuff there. That's some stuff that like you definitely won't get out of a PDF parser often. The actual descriptions of the images, that's pretty cool. However, devil's in the details. And the devil is definitely in the details here in that these are not accurate tables, unfortunately. It looks so good, and I really want it to be accurate, but they are not. And you can see here, we've got these ability scores, 9 through 18, and you got minus 15, minus 10, minus 5, that works. But then these last three are just completely wrong. They've started adding some values to this table that don't actually exist in the original document, and they've got this column's completely wrong. This last column's completely wrong, too. It's missing values, and it's moved values around a little bit. And, you know, it tried. It did a really good job. And this is an old, kind of grainy PDF. I'll give it that. But there's still some issues here that still need to be kind of worked through. And so even with probably the better of the two image document, it approaches toward looking at a PDF, we still have some problems to look at. But I think these are very, like, human fixable problems. A lot of what I had to do with the existing one is I kind of loaded it up, fixed a lot of the OCR errors with GPT, and then went back in myself and kind of like plugged away at some stuff. But I think this kind of shows you that like, okay, there's a new way of doing this stuff. It wasn't even this good just last week, but now it's getting pretty good at being able to actually read out details of a PDF. And I wouldn't look at raw text anymore. There might be a much better way of kind of going through this and figuring it out. And, you know, I think there's other pieces of content that are going to be important. So, like, I wouldn't just load this up. I think there's other metadata that's important. The page number that it's on, I think, is important. The sections that are involved. I would load up the table of contents and have this page associated with where it is in the table of contents and use that to bring in some of the metadata here. I would have the prompt try and break it up into sections so that, like, this section up here with the dexterity table is tied to the text below until it starts talking about constitution. And then constitution is all kind of linked together. The constitution table and the notes for the table are linked together. Some way of sort of grouping those in a way that those could be the documents in the vector store. I think something around that would be pretty good too. And then I think, of course, the images and diagrams. I think adding stuff to this prompt to say, hey, if this image looks like it has meaning with the context of the text here, it'd be great to bring that in as well. So that's all sorts of stuff that I would kind of be looking at and kind of playing with. So to kind of round this out, one thing I wanted to do is just give kind of an idea of what I would do if I were building a PDF ingestion pipeline today. Because I think this is like maybe something that'll help you if you're one of these people who are like looking at PDFs, you're watching this video, you're like, man, I just wish I could like figure out how to like put this all together to make something cool. I think this is how you do it. So here's what I'd do. I would bring in your PDFs, put them into an ingestion pipeline. And all this is just like loop through every page in that PDF, right? You're pulling off each individual page and you're doing two things. You're creating the metadata associated with that page and you're uploading the page to an image hosting service like S3, something like that. You're going to then send that URL to OpenAI and you're going to parse that image along with some prompting to be able to bring you back a document. And then that document or set of documents is going to be able to bring this metadata across that'll have like your table of contents information, what sections this is in, what page things are on. All that stuff will be brought into the documents. This image parser is, of course, going to break this up into multiple documents, right? Because there's possibly more sections on the page. Each of those sections is going to get associated with some amount of metadata. And then that is going to go out the PDF ingestion pipeline into a vector store. And that gives you all of those documents in a really good state. They've been parsed out. You've attached metadata to them. You've gotten as much data as you can out of the PDF. You've put that into documents. You've broken that up into chunks. And now you've got those available for a vector store. So if I ask a question about, you know, how do I swim? It'll give me a really good answer and possibly even describe what swimming looks like in this game, or what things look like based on a diagram or something else that's important inside of a PDF. This latest model and these multimodal models have really changed how I think about parsing PDFs. I had this, you know, pretty good system before. I thought it worked pretty well. But honestly, I think image parsing is going to be really kind of giving a lot of systems a run for their money. I think this is a cool new way of doing this sort of work. And I'm excited to see, you know, how everyone here in this community kind of uses this, adopts it, tries to build cool stuff with it. And I'll try to follow up as I kind of build new stuff with it too. I'm hoping to get a chance to kind of loop back into some of this and try building some cool new stuff. Well, thanks very much for coming and tuning in today. We're really happy with 1,000 subscribers. We appreciate it if you become another one of them, if you're not already. We'd also appreciate a like and a follow along with our blog here on Stable Discussion. We talk about a lot of different things, and we try and keep all of that up to date in our writing and our channel here, talking about AI and how to pragmatically kind of look at AI and what things are unfolding. There's a lot of hype, there's a lot of marketing, and we try and keep things pretty grounded here. So, awesome. Thanks so much. Have a good one.